Globalization is defined as the capacity to move and the potential movement across nations of trade, investment, technology, finance, and labor.
An important result of globalization is that it allows different populations to spread their ideas around the world. Globalization also leads to an increase in international trade and regional integration.
It is ironical that worldwide anti-globalization movements often portray Gandhi as someone who shared the same side of the ideological spectrum, when in fact Gandhi himself was clearly a product of globalization. He was educated in London, started his political activities in South Africa before he even joined the political arena in India, and was greatly influenced by Western figures such as Tolstoy and Ruskin.
Though Gandhi supported globalization, he was fully aware of the dangers associated with it. He predicted that colonialism, both cultural and political, industrialization and commercialization of the economy would lead to class antagonism and environmental hazards.
Though Gandhi criticized industrialization as it exploited the nation's natural resources, he did not harbor any ill will against foreigners and was not against global collaboration. His criticisms remain valid even in today's world, and it becomes clear that he would have supported globalization even more if it was effective in removing poverty and environmental health was not compromised. Rabindranath Tagore's words seem apt to describe Gandhi's equally weighed support and critique towards globalization.
"We have, for over a century, been dragged by the prosperous West behind its chariot, choked by the dust, deafened by the noise, humbled by our own helplessness, and overwhelmed by the speed. We agreed to acknowledge that this chariot drive was progress, and the progress was civilization. If we ever ventured to ask, progress towards what, and progress for whom, it was peculiarly and ridiculously oriental to entertain such ideas about the absoluteness of progress. Of late, a voice has come to us to take count not only of the scientific perfection of the chariot, but of the depth of the ditches lying in its path.